President Rodrigo Duterte on Monday ordered the Philippine Health Insurance Corporation not to compel overseas Filipino workers to pay PhilHealth premiums. That's after OFWs were outraged over the PhilHealth order requiring OFWs to pay higher rates. For a reaction, we are joined by Kay Marites Palma. She's a co-founder of Social Justice for Migrant Workers. Marites, thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, thank you so much too for letting me join this.
Now, President Duterte said PhilHealth contributions will be voluntary. There's now a moratorium on collections from direct members, but the PhilHealth is making the contribution flexible for OFWs and the self-employed. What's your reaction to this?
Yeah, we are not happy with the moratorium they have issued. We want a total abolition of this law, so we are not happy yet for the information they will give to the OFWs that we are not already included, but we're still fighting for it.
You're currently collecting signatures against this hike in contribution. What is the goal of these signatures? What is your appeal to PhilHealth, President Duterte, and government?
Yeah, we demand total abolition because we don't know when they will implement again. They said they will suspend this time, but after coronavirus, we are not sure if they will put it back again. Then the pressure will be put us again. So we demand total abolition of this law.
The abolition of the law means the universal health care law would be negated, but some lawmakers are offering to take another look at that particular clause that makes it mandatory for overseas exit clearance, so you cannot be prevented from leaving the country, and mandatory the raising of the rates. Which one are you against, or both?
Yeah, we are against to all of this. We just want the voluntary because that is normal for us. That me also, like, I have my PhilHealth. I am paying regularly, but in regular contribution. But this mandatory, and they base our contributions, our salary, like, it's oppressive. It's unjust to us as OFWs.
Now, supposing the PhilHealth contribution does not become a requirement for the OEC now, how many OFWs do you think will stop their contributions to PhilHealth?
I think because of what has happened recently, that families of domestic workers or overseas workers are not, or they don't give support. We call this like the ACAP and the ayuda, you know, the ayuda. Mm-hmm. Like, many of our families back home, like, didn't receive this ayuda because they said that they are the families of OFWs. So I think this hurt the Filipino migrant workers because they, like, they separated, and then they just forget about the families of the OFWs. So I think this one will increase the rage towards the government that they will not pay the PhilHealth anymore.
Are you saying that, do you think that OFWs might actually stop their contributions to PhilHealth at this point?
Yes, some might stop paying because of this, what happened. And then maybe some will continue paying the contributions because they still have their beneficiaries. But for me, like, my daughter is already 19 years old, so she is not dependent anymore. So what's the use of paying this PhilHealth? And in my experience, during 2015, I have an operation and my bill is 100,000, but my PhilHealth deduction is only 20,000. So how come, like, it's so little, you know? Mm. So, like, those who are willing to pay, then, because it's just a voluntary, then we don't oblige them to stop. They will pay if they want, but for those who doesn't like to pay because they don't have already dependent, then they should have the right not to pay anymore.
Understood. Talk about the beneficiaries. Isa sa mga impormasyon na nakuha natin mula dun sa pag-uusap ng tungkol sa issue is that 3.6 million na mga OFWs out of the 10 million who are PhilHealth members 1 billion pesos of the premiums were collected, pero 1.7 billion pesos actually yung nagastos para dun sa OFWs na yun at para sa mga pamilya nila. So, ibig sabihin, yung mga pamilya actually nakaka-benepisyo dito sa PhilHealth na ito. So, bakit aayaw ang mga OFWs sa pagbabaya dito ng premium?
Totoo ba yung parang hindi naman, parang hindi kami magpaniwala sa data na yan na ganun kalaki yung binibigay? Kasi karamihang pamilya ng mga OFWs na nandito sa Hong Kong, pagdating sa bill sa hospital, hindi naman po nabibigyan ng justisya. Halimbawa, yung anak ng mga members ko, nagkaroon ng dengue. Magkano ang bill ng dengue? Konti lang ang natanggal sa bill nila sa dengue. So, paano nila sasabihin malaki ang naitutulong sa mga OFWs? So, parang hindi naman lahat yata nabibigyan ng tamang deduction.
Tsaka,
pili lang kung anong sakit yata ang nabibigyan ng full help sa PhilHealth.
At isa sa mga punto ng mga OFWs is that because nasa ibang bansa nga sila, yung medical at health benefits ay kinukuha nila mula dun sa host country nila at hindi kagad sa Pilipinas. Tama ba yun?
Opo. Meron po kaming health insurance po dito sa Hong Kong. Kapag pumunta ka sa hospital ay libre po. Basta may kontrata ka po, libreng nakaka-avail kami ng hospitalization dito sa Hong Kong. So, yun, dahil in-insure kami ng aming mga amo, so free po kami sa pagpapagamot dito.
So mukhang tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang diskusyon tungkol dito sa PhilHealth hike in contribution rates. We hope you will continue to keep your lines open. Thank you so much for joining us today. Marites Palma, co-founder of the Social Justice for Migrant Workers. We appreciate you being with us. Thank you.